EWS.
The Overnight Underground Podcast. Here's the headlines. Chowderheads abound in open states. Trump will bring back the coronavirus press circuses. Wear a face mask or start shooting. A Kentucky woman invents the convertible face mask. And hey, Wendy's.
Where's the beef?
These stories and more coming up on today's Overnight Underground News. I'm John Ford. Half-wits abound after some states have relaxed their stay-at-home order. In Texas, beaches in some areas are looking more like bumper-to-bumper flesh. So much for social distancing. In Port Aransas, just up the coast from Corpus Christi, one local posted pictures on Facebook that shows beachgoers have traded social distancing for social indifference. The beaches in Port Aransas have been off limits for about a month before opening up over the weekend. It is indeed, as one local put it, a jungle out there. On Miami Beach, South Point Park was forced to shut down 5 days after it reopened. According to the Miami Herald, park rangers issued nearly 9,000 verbal warnings to park goers for not wearing facial coverings. Here's an idea. Just tell the Miami Beach douchebags that surgical mask tan lines are all the rage, and everyone will be wearing one before you know it. Across the state in Clearwater, Florida, beachgoers are using seaweed to create social distancing boundaries, blocking off the section around their little beach encampments. In California, Governor Newsom has caved and is loosening restrictions on his stay-at-home order this week. The retail sector will start to reopen in California with curbside pickup, and Newsom said that the state is looking to move into phase two.
Energize main phases. All weapons to full power.
All weapons to full power. Energize.
The president said yesterday that his coronavirus press conferences will return. They just won't be back on a daily basis.
Oh, thank God.
As reported in the Daily News, Trump said that, quote, everybody, unquote, enjoyed his White House coronavirus briefings and rambled on about how great the ratings were. Mr. Trump, please define everybody.
Define parameters.
The president also took verbal pot shots at a couple of reporters. That didn't stop the press from taking a few shots back at President Trump yesterday. Here's MSNBC's Joe Scarborough using his bully pulpit and airtime to call out Trump to take a rest for not being well.
Mr. President, I ask that you get checked out. I ask that you take a rest. I ask that you take care of yourself. Maybe let Mike Pence run things for the next week. You're not well.
Well, here's some good news.
Good news, everyone!
Of course, I jest. According to the LA Times, there's a mutant coronavirus strain out there spreading coast to coast that is more infectious than the first round. Scientists at Los Alamos National Laboratory, who conducted the study that exhumed the new strain, say it is now the dominant strain worldwide. The new strain, according to the eggheads, may also make infectees vulnerable to a second infection after a first bout with COVID-19.
Relax. We're doing great. It all will pass.
So how much longer should we all just lock ourselves down in the basement? That's a good question. Biden may know. He seems to have gotten pretty good at hiding in his.
I think that's a little too harsh.
If the security guard won't let you into the store because your kid isn't wearing a face mask, why, just shoot them, of course.
For my mother, my grandmother, my father, my uncle, and for the common good, I must now kill you.
A woman along with her husband and son are being charged with murder in Flint, Michigan. Must be something in the water there. After shooting the security guard at a local Family Dollar store, the guard, who was enforcing the state's face mask policy, reportedly refused the family entrance to the store because their daughter wasn't wearing a face mask. The woman, Charmel Teague, I guess it's pronounced sort of like Charmin and Carmel combined. Charmel? Her mother must have loved Werther's and toilet paper. That's all I can think of. Anyway, she argued with the guard and then allegedly shot him in the back of the head. No matter where you live, humans seem to often be universally stupid. A woman in Kentucky, it seems, has been cutting holes in her mask, exposing her mouth and nose just to make it easier to breathe. A gas station clerk at the SJ Food Mart in Lexington spotted the mask-wearing Mensa member and asked her about her clever custom mask attire.
Where'd you get that mask from?
Well, since we have to wear them and it makes it harder to breathe, this makes it a lot easier to breathe.
Cutting it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll do that too. Thanks for the advice.
The video's already received more than 800,000 likes on TikTok. As we continue to take a nice leisurely stroll down the Isle of Morons, a Florida woman has been busted for exposing her non-lockdown breasts. The Smoking Gun reports that a 56-year-old Vero Beach woman was clearing out her garage topless in full horrific view of her neighbors, who of course called the cops on Lady Garage Diva. The woman, according to the neighbors in the police report, quote, bent over with her top down and started pounding on her blue plastic recycling bin, making sure that the victim and the kids were looking. Victim? Of course, it can't be unseen, and no amount of eye bleach can cure it, but victim?
I've never seen such big ones before.
Hey, Wendy's?
Where's the beef?
That's exactly what some customers are asking the fast food hamburger chain. Meat shortages have caused Wendy's to take burgers off the menu at a number of its stores in California and across the nation. It's reported that somewhere in the neighborhood of a fifth of Wendy's U.S. restaurants are lacking meat. Bloomberg reports that some customers have taken to Twitter complaining.
You gotta be kidding me.
And you may have noticed that your groceries have been taking a price hike. Milk prices are up 10% and eggs have risen 30%. Sweden has a novel way of keeping people out of parks during their lockdown. In the city of Lund, which usually draws crowds numbering in the tens of thousands to celebrate Valpurgis Night in Central Park, decided the best way to deal with the revelers was using chicken shit. No, seriously. Officials in the Swedish city will dump more than a ton of chicken poop onto the park. According to the newspaper, the chairman of the Lund Council's environmental committee said, quote, "We get the opportunity to fertilize the lawns, but at the same time it will stink, and so it may not be so nice to sit and drink a beer in the park."
You gotta be shitting me.
Now there's an election promise if I ever heard one.
N-E-W-S.
A mostly correct and occasionally incomplete transcript and links to reference sources and articles of this Overnight Underground can be found at overnightunderground.com.